Greetings and welcome back to Long War 2. We're in the middle of an HQ assault and we just found our first lovely chrysalids. Now the big question is, do we engage them? Pull them? Or do we try to set an overwatch trap? They might have lightning reflexes or shadow step or some bullshit like that, so I feel like opening up on our terms is probably the best approach here.
Let's do this!
Since we do have Shredder on Daniel here, so I think we just dead-eye the soldier, shred some of that armor, do a good amount of damage. I've been using dead-eye so much, like, in this mission more than in the entire XCOM 2 game since release. Yeah, not anymore, it isn't. Okay, that looks like an opportunity for some trench gun.
If you say so.
Yeah. Sold. Do we have anyone here who can take two shots? Well, you only have one target, but you can take two shots on that.
I always scratch them.
And scratch him some more.
Target eliminated.
Okay, where's Cynthia? Back here. Kinda wanna get some kills in on the new guys. Except can take a shot from there, that's fine.
I got it right.
Down to 13. I'm still hearing a turret in this general area. Probably more like here. Also, this laser barrier looks weird.
Alright. On my way.
I'm on the move.
Let's make at least a little bit of ground here.
Overwatch.
Here I come.
Overwatch. Reload, move up. Perfect. That's a nasty group. So, once again, let's check how close we can move to them before we activate. We're like 5 tiles away. Thing is, if I kill them now, which I probably can, I've got 100% on Centurion. If I really kill them this turn, then, like, kill one of them and pull the others, then I might not have enough shots to really deal with them. So I think I need to fall back, probably to this line, or like complete out of sight.
I'm trusting you here. On the move.
Derium can stay there. Harvey needs to move up.
On your order. Affirmative. Covering now.
I'm on it.
Andy can move
on
up
your
here.
Order. Got it covered. Got it covered. Let's rock!
Okay, what are the odds of them revealing me? slim to none, they just might lock me into position depending on where they move. So that's just... I kind of want to keep vision on them though. That's a great spot.
The others surely didn't come this way.
That's stealth. Running through the open space and they're like, what?
They'll pay for that.
That must have been a tumbleweed.
We're green to go.
Yeah, and we're green to go.
I guess that'll be okay.
Oh, what? Why do you have a shot from there? That doesn't make any sense.
That's why we need armor.
Well, that's not why we need armor, that's why this should be complete line of sight blocking. What kind of crap is that? Look at that. Okay, so... she's actually exposed here. Yeah. That's so frustrating. It's unbelievable that these kind of issues are still in the game. Okay. Even if I move up here, I don't get them both, so... this might be finally the moment where we pop the... up to 45.
What's over there?
And pop those guys.
Close quarters.
And of course this thing is still there. I'm so mad right now. Unbelievable.
If you say so.
Okay. Could you pop that mutant for me?
Target's still up.
Probably not. Shots do we have? We've got 100 on the one in cover, obviously 100 on the one in open, 96 on the shock trooper. Like, he's the hardest one to kill here out of the bunch.
I'm on it.
So let's see if we can kill the rest. We've got an okay, let's chain shot the mutant on the back. That was 50% good. He's still alive. I mean, if I have these weird spots, I might as well use them, right?
Finally.
Okay. No, I'm just not gonna comment on it, so... yeah. Some great able shit. Here you see that mutant, and if you move up there, also only that one. It's 5 HP. Let's see if we can double tap the shock trooper.
Ah,
Decent start. Trick shot for the second one. And once again, okay, so if you get the kill with your first shot from double tap, then you've got death from above. Second shot doesn't trigger it. Why? Because screw you, that's why. Okay, can probably come here and take a shot at the exposed muton, I guess.
Headed there now.
57, that's horrible. What else do I have? Okay, scooter. Only good thing you can do here. Let's take a shot at that muton at 50%. Light him up.
Adjusting sights.
Not happening. So you only have a flashbang maybe available. So I could command someone to hopefully kill the muton in the back. Best candidate for that is probably Cynthia, because she has locked on. No, Andy also has locked on, so he's the better target for that. Okay, and for my first action, I do have Salvo now, right? Okay. Start airdropping. Okay, command. Do we rely on a 91 or do we use hail of bullets? It's gonna be fine. Come on, Andy, I know you can do it. Perfect. And that cover didn't even get destroyed by the grenade. That's some sturdy barrier here. I want some of that. Hang on. No, you can't take a shot, you don't have any action anyway, so that's just combat protocol to get some peace and quiet here. And yeah. So that line of sight there, that could have been a dead soldier, like she was exposed. So 40-50% to crit. Your next turn, and you're the turn after that. Which also means no technical for the supply rate.
Let's do this!
Which is coming up next, which is the reason why I'm doing the HQ assault at this time. Oh. Oh. That's a lot of hit points, Mr. General. I'm thinking we might want to take position in these towers. Also, yeah, about that. I want to heal, I want to airdrop. I want to get you somewhere where you're kind of out of line of sight and able to do some run and gun flanking action. I should put the tower between me and them.
Go, go, go!
You can come up there. would we do this with the healing?
Let's do this.
Come here. I mean, 4 HP heal is feels a bit wasted. Oh, you know what we can do once the combat starts? Oh, give me one of those turrets. Anyway. Do we heal here? Yeah, let's heal.
You're
fine, don't worry about it. Got you. Also, airdrop. You know, I kind of start to value the bombardier perk, which gives you 20% more range on your grenades. Feel like one of the main uses of it could be to drop grenades on a pod that's not activated yet. That's something I really need to test with a grenadier at some point. Okay, what's the best position to keep eye on everything? I've got Ghostwalker next turn. They shouldn't come. I don't think they run all the way here. I think the command pod usually stays out in the back. What's happening with this building?
Oh, yeah.
Just gonna steady here, Cynthia. Does he want you somewhere on this side? And we don't have another tower.
No need to ask twice.
Yeah, and Aaron. Let's bring you in here first.
Here I come.
Who did they spot? Oh, probably the people in the tower already? Oh, that's not what I wanted to have happen here. Two more drones. Drone reveal animations are the best. Like, absolutely. Repair? Did the general, like, flank himself? Was that a hit through high cover? For 9 damage, are you serious right now? Okay. That's a lot of dudes. That's a lot of dudes. Where's the general? Okay, 100% to crit. Oh, you have bring him on, right? Oh, that's gonna be fun. Look at that damage. That double tap could, in theory, kill the general. Let's see. That's a crit for 18 after armor. General down to 6 HP. Oh, you can get a rocket off. Come on. I know you can do it. That went somewhere. so many enemies. I mean, we need to hack something here, right? Tempted to go for the drone because I have a higher chance to control it. Chance to crit is like nothing. Can we drop anything here? Not really far. Okay, let's think about priorities. Longbow seems like a big priority. Which we... I don't think we see the longbow on the back. Where's the flank shot on the general? A shot, but not a flank shot. Okay, I think this might be cyclic fire time on the heavy mech.
Target eliminated.
Him. Anything to deal with, to deal the finishing blow to the general? That's my question here. Like, I'm tempted to just kill the stuff that has line of sight on me, so which is most likely the archer. Hack the drone so they have an alternative target. I probably need to command Cosmos to move back to complete line of sight blocking, which we know how that works. Bit concerned about the Rocketeer, bit concerned about the DerAva Longbow. But at this point, we can't kill it all. We are too far away from most of them. Okay, let's check. Don't hold any. Cynthia. You only see the longbow anyway. Archer, whatever. Alternatively, I can just move here, execute the general, and at that point command and conceal. Like, I'm tempted to just fall back with Cosmos and hack from there, hack from range in the first place. Like, there's no point not moving, hacking, and then moving if I just can move. Now, the risk is that someone could move up and do something to me.
Affirmative, moving out.
Grab that bot.
Just 71 to control. Game of lies here. Doing its job again.
We're good to go.
So, I guess Scooter needs to take 236% shots. Now, one thing I want to check here. He has Tech Sense. So if I can get a flashbang onto him, I can remove that.
Press the attack.
Which should turn it into 251s, which is acceptable. Let's see. Yeah, still, this whole position here could be really bad with the longbow.
X-ray neutralized.
Actually tempted to move Scooter out of the way.
If you say so. Overwatch.
Yeah, let's bring him over here.
On the move.
Just less targets, make it less juicy target for the longbow. And over here we conceal and GTFO. Probably all the way to the flank here. Let me just double check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yep. Just want to make sure that I see everyone who's active so I don't run into any surprises. Okay. Talk about less juicy targets. I think I also move Mr. Daddy. I'm still tempted to command Cosmos and get him even further away. Or hunkered or something. He just needs to get away. Problem is, if anyone gets vision on me, I either eat a longbow AoE or the squad side turrets will do their work. So it doesn't matter how far away I am. If someone gets vision, well, that kinda is the whole point, right? Okay, let's just rely on these spots again. I mean, this was kind of open, but these spots do not provide any line of sight for me, so.
Head now.
Yeah, also, if he dies or gets knocked unconscious, then the drone hack ends. That's perfect. Okay, the drone just needs to survive the Rocketeer's action. Oh, and the Rocketeer is in a flank position to my sniper. Oh, that tanky drone. MVP. It only hit the armor. Because that drone is just one step into my detection range. I hate turrets with a burning passion. Like, okay. Without long war, you were just ignoring turrets, right? Because who cares? But this unlimited squad side really takes the piss. Anyway. How do we do this? We need vision on this thing. We need to somehow deal with the longbow. Who moved? Hey, these mechs, they really have a way to move into a position where nobody can shoot at them.
Back in. On your order.
Down to 5. I mean, I could just take from here. Wait, I do have slug shot.
Okay, I'll go.
Which is still only a 74. Hang on, are you telling me I don't get any range penalties? No. Slugshot, the value ability. Okay.
I definitely got that one.
That's that problem solved. You obviously need a reload.
Let's do this.
I mean, yeah, okay. Kill the drone.
Hostile target down.
Another turret, and I hear another one, and I don't have line of sight on those guys. That was really the whole point here. Can I get into the turret tower? Only there. That's not good enough. Okay, which means you've got a shot on the Rocketeer. Oh, you've got plenty of shots. Dead eye that Rocketeer for 94% to crit. Good night, sweet prince.
That's how it's done.
So, what else do we have? Any chance we can get a shot on the... that engineer. Yes, we can from here. Also from over there. Which... No, I don't think that's flank territory.
Let's move already!
Okay, down to two enemies. But they are so far away. Also, three turrets. Highway has cooldown, so. I'm wondering, like, depending on where they move, the turrets get line of sight, right? So. Eren isn't. Possible turret danger, centipede maybe. The drone was here and was spotting Andy, so that's also dangerous position. But Andy is already not on full HP. So he gets an 8 protocol. Just stay here. Cynthia.
I'm ready. What's over there?
Free reload, move up, overwatch. That Vanguard, 95 aim.
Got it covered.
I wish I brought something like smoke or something like that. I guess that's okay. The thing is, they really don't know where I am, so they will not make smart moves. Well, they kinda do. That turret is line of sight on Cynthia now. Also on Eren. Okay, I think I concentrate on killing these two guys, and then I don't need to destroy the turrets.
Ready to go.
So we got 100% and a 96. Let's double tap the 96, because that 100 is sitting there in half cover, much easier to kill. Single tap works for me. Means we can hold a target the Vanguard. /271, Cynthia. Yeah, let him have it.
Positive confirmation. Area secured. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
36 enemies on the map, 33 killed, 17 turns. That's actually decent speed here. Three and of my guys got wounded, one of them due to total bullshit on our side. That also means with three people wounded, we have less people available for that supply raid. Three kills in a turn? Someone's been manipulating the stats here, I think. That's what's the skill called? Cyclic fire. Because he took three shots on that mech, and that mech died due to these three shots, that's three kills. Don't question it. Makes sense. If you think about it. It doesn't. But at the end of the day, that was an HQ assault. We've got a liberated region and we've sent in a group of, well, a group without any Master Sergeants except for Sniper. So, you definitely need some tech sense. I don't see the value in Salvo. I mean, yeah, you might have two rockets, three with concussion, four with bunker buster, then kind of, but as long as you just run around with a single rocket, it's like, yeah, one time permission, I get an extra action. Like, this hurts the most because specialists are so valuable, I think. Anyway, so let's take a Reaper here. And you get grazing fire, so your rapid reaction shots have a higher chance to hit. Also nice aim progression here. And lots of loot. Elite scope, advanced hair trigger, crap, and bunch of corpses, 183 supplies, 4 data pads. Yeah, that was another elite hair trigger. Oh, and we can finally do chrysalid autopsy. Sweet. So, one thing I wanted to do here quickly is not squad management. Diamond Shark. Congratulations. Where is Cynthia? Did I already assign her to the squad? Okay, yeah, I did. So what to say, Cynthia is now a part of the squad. Also, why I'm here, let's, I think Rebecca has been with Swarm Squad in the last few missions, so has someone else. No, I don't think so. Anyway, that's supply rate, right? 5 people wounded, 24 still unavailable out on missions. Or is, does unavailable count people out on missions, and people wounded, and Haven Advisors, and people training? Who knows? Who cares? East Asia. First things first. Everyone, I guess, supplies. Surprising no one. Now, do I set a Master Sergeant in here to make sure that we don't have any faceless left? Or do I just say, yeah, screw it, we've got one engineer available. Let's go max supplies here. I really wanted to go max supplies. I could also build a relay, but I don't think that pays off in ever. Okay, max supplies here. Supply rate. Talking about supplies.
Setting course for the Eastern U.S. precinct.
Yeah, that looks like a good start for the squad. We need some heavy weapons. bring in Nanook. Nanook. I mean, he's Master Sergeant. He has 90 aim, so let's bring in Nuke. 6 days, 18. Don't trust extremely light. I would kind of like a specialist. Which would the Debbie, I guess. Eight days, 2 hours. Perfect. Okay, most of the guys already have the gear, so let's not make any compromises. Let's build weapons. We need another Gauss long rifle. We need a scatter gun. We need a Gauss cannon. We're almost out of advice. Do I leave the setup in? Nah, I think I'll put a cut in here. I'll equip these guys with the proper gear, weapon attachments, etc. And then we'll send them on the way to do that supply raid. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.